All right, we're here at my VermiHut indoor worm tower, but let's get started by seeing what happened to that jack-o'-lantern face we put in here. It has actually been 54 days since we put that in here and filmed it for about 12 days or so. And since then, we've been on a couple trips and I've also fed it, but let's kind of talk about what we saw. So between day 0 and 2, almost all the eggshell grit was gone and we had some mold starting to form. Now the worms started to surround the pumpkin on the outside and in that little dinosaur hole by day 3 and 4. And then starting on day 6, the worms found the top of the pumpkin, and by day 9 they had almost completely devoured it except for that little heavily molded piece of pumpkin up at the top there. But by day 11 just the pumpkin skin is left along with some chunks of coffee grounds, and the worms had totally spread out in the bin. So none of that is left here, and what you see on top is just a little bit of shredded cardboard that I had put down because 6 weeks ago we put a lettuce stalk in there and I actually thought it was frozen, but it started to grow on me. And then 4 weeks ago we gave them some celery stalks, a tomato top, some cucumber peels, some pear cores, and then some bedding and amendments. And I think that's what we're seeing right here on the top. And then 2 weeks ago, we gave it an apple core, banana peel, and a lettuce stalk. But we have not fed underneath at all. Everything has been a top feeding. So I don't know what this is going to look like because it was the oldest inoculating tray and then got rotated up here because that was the last video we did, was a rotation video. So let's kind of scrape and see where the worms are. I'm already starting to see there is a bunch right here, and this may be where that apple core was. I'll just kind of go underneath, although I set it on the top. It looks like the drippings have got them excited because right there, oh my gosh, there is a massive worm ball right there. And I don't know what they are after, but it must be that apple core. I guess they might be, yep, it is, because here it is. Here's that apple core, just a piece of it right there. And let me see, yeah. Clearly they expect to be fed a lot more than they've gotten fed. And we are gonna do just that because the experiment that we're gonna do is we're gonna blend up some food and we're gonna put the exact same amount of food on the other side and we're gonna see how they do with it. But let's just kind of put these right here and do a little time lapse. Speed it up and watch the worm ball kind of shake around. But I'm just going to set them to the side and I'm going to keep digging in because I want to see if there is a lot of the shredded cardboard that made up the old inoculating tray and see if they actually ate most of it and turn it into worm castings, because typically in about another week is when I would be rotating. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to add more food and I'm actually going to add some more bedding in here to kind of fluff it up because I haven't been giving them a lot of bedding when I'm just kind of doing these top feeding. So it is pretty impressive that before that last feeding, all that was in here was shredded cardboard and it initially went in dry and I haven't mixed any of it throughout. So anything on the edges here where there was no food at all, this is all just the worms kind of eating away that cardboard, and they eat both the bedding and the food. So it definitely looks highly populated. I mean, we are seeing lots of worms all over, and this is a mix of both red wigglers and blue worms, and it's been going for just about 3 years. So I haven't seen one outcompete the other in that time. So no worry about that if you've got a worm mix. So let's aerate a little bit and then we will add more bedding and mix it all around. All right, this top feeding tray is looking really good. The moisture level is perfect. I've just kind of picked some of this long-term food that I think came to us in the old top feeding tray that is now the pre-harvest tray. So we're gonna go ahead and mix this in, but we're also gonna put a bunch of bedding in here and kind of mix it all around. And there, right there, is our worm ball that's still going. So in we go with bedding, and even more, and then one more. So I'm just gonna take the time here to kind of mix it around. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to bury these worms here, because what we really want is for them to come up top and kind of discover stuff. I don't want to favor one side or the other. So now I'm just going to kind of smooth it out, and then we'll get set up for our experiment. So here is what we had in mind to feed, and everything that you see in here is also in here. So this right here is a beet, and we'll put that right there. We've got a apple core right there. We've got several grapes that will go all in that corner right there. We've got a piece of broccoli. We've got some pomegranate skin, so I'll put some of it down and then some of it up, just like that right there. We've got a juicy lettuce stalk right there. Finish up grapes, a strawberry top, and then one more right there. Then finally, we'll round it out with some banana peels. A little bit right there. We've got some space right here. And maybe a line drawing through the center right there. Now, one of the questions I get asked a lot is, should you blend your food? And you certainly can, and it definitely kind of increases the surface area. But one of the problems with kind of blending your food is that if it goes in a big bowl like this, it's really hard for the worms to get all the way into the center, and then it can kind of ferment, and then it'll take them a while to get to it. So we're gonna do a little bit of a double experiment here. We're gonna leave a blob right there in the middle. Then I'm also gonna take some and spread it out as much as I can here. We're gonna see if they go for the spread out kind of blended food here, or if they like the blob better, or the food that I have over here. Now, all of this food has been frozen. Everything here was frozen. Everything here was frozen and then thawed and then blended up. And I think I'm gonna do just a kind of a baby chunk and spread that out as well. So we'll see. The worms will sense all this, and they will come up and take a bite out of everything, and we'll see how fast they go, because every single day, in fact, probably twice a day, we're gonna pop the lid off and then see how much progress they've made and form it into a time lapse. So there are some things I call amendments that we feed at every feeding, and one of them is eggshell grit. I'm gonna put just a little bit right here, and what we will find is that the first thing that the worms go for is this stuff right here. They use it for their gizzard to try and make their food smaller within their digestive system, kind of like a bird, but for some reason I always see them pop up immediately, just like we did in that earlier time lapse, and go for the eggshell grit. So we've got some right there, and then we'll put a little bit right here as well. The other thing I like to do is take my expired grains like cornstarch or sugars or flours, put them in my magic bullet blender, and then blend them up into what we call a worm chow, and I'll just put a little bit here on the side, and maybe a little bit right here as well. And what I found when I do these top feedings, just like we saw, is that when it kind of gets chunked up or built up right here, it takes the worm just a little bit longer to eat it all. But if you do a light spreading, they kind of attack it a lot quicker. And finally, I've got some coffee grounds that I just kind of put in this container and save them as we go. And I'm just gonna put a little bit right there. Let me break that up. Oh, nice and moldy. We'll see how they go for that mold. And maybe I'll put a little bit right here with my hands. Same thing too. I've noticed when it's kind of piled high, it takes them a little bit longer to get to it. So we'll kind of spread it out. So check it out. This is going to be a really cool feeding. Everything from here over is the same as everything from here over. The only difference is it has been blended. So let's see how the worms attack this and what they go for first, second, third, fifth, 100th. 100th. Want to see some of my other top feeding time lapses, I'll attach a couple of videos to them right here. So I hope you're having a great day. I hope your worm bins are doing fantastic. So happy vermicomposting, everybody. Take care now.